You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio.
What's good? This is your girl, Draya Ivy, introducing my new show, Ivy Talks, the dopest podcast coming out of the beautiful city that is Miami, Florida, featuring the best artist interviews, covering the illest events in the city as we propel the culture of hip-hop and R&B. Make sure to check out Ivy Talks each and every Monday from 11 p.m. to midnight on iLive UK, changing the way you listen to radio. Let's talk, talk, talk.
Yo, yo, yo.
Yo, 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 yo. What's good? Welcome to Ivy Talks episode number 9. This is your lovely and beautiful host. Yes, because I am that fly. Draya Ivy. I do need some drops. Good point.
You get a soundboard. You tell me, like,
I don't know if that was a bomb or a motorboat.
And I'm sitting here beside my lovely and amazing fancy co-host.
Very
fancy.
Is that the
fancy.
Fedora?
That's the fedora. A la Joe Button.
Old school, new school, need to learn those. Nah, you know, light skin, bearded, you know, fading in the hair. That's what we do.
Nah, you look good, though. You look good, though.
It's kind of a little breezy outside this weekend, so, you know, I'm just chilling.
All right.
Good? Holla Rock. What up? Lex in the building.
Lex is in the building. What's good, look? How you doing?
Tremendous.
Your one-word answers are always so great.
But that's what works, though.
I know. Men are so short with words, huh?
Mars is with words, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Hey-o!
Mars versus Venus. Are you just trying to get some likes up in here?
Nah, with what? That retrograde stuff?
You trying to get your Instagram likes up?
Nah. We don't need no Instagram likes.
They control
it anyway.
Oh, that's true.
We just need listeners,
the
baby.
The alleged algorithms. But wait. So, before we even get into that, how's everyone doing? Everyone's good?
Yeah.
Everyone's had a good week, good weekend? Anything eventful happen?
In personal life or just like, you know,
whatever,
news and media?
Whatever you want to share. Whatever you would like to share.
Nah,
maybe good news?
Wait.
Maybe good news?
I don't know. You know, I'll be drawing a blank till last minute.
Okay, all right. What about you, Luke?
Got nothing at the moment. On the good news front.
Yeah, you know, it's just
productive. That's all.
Can't think of anything that stands out.
Moving.
Yeah.
Moving.
All right. Let's get it started. One of the primary topics for today that I wanted to bring up, since basically the whole world is involved in this, and this magical two-word term is called social media.
Yeah.
And the latest, even though some were privy to this months ago, is that Instagram is now not allowing other people to view your likes. And allegedly, they are claiming that the reason that they're doing this is to minimize the level of, I guess you could say, insecurities, and also to alleviate some form of depression with people comparing themselves constantly to other people who they feel, well, this person is getting this many likes and I don't have that many likes, and I threw up this picture and no one likes it, and you know, and although that
does she have her clothes on?
Oh no. Well, come on, you already know that that's going to get mad likes.
Yeah, of course. You know, it depends who, because some of the people just need to just
believe it,
start doing pictures just with plain black lights on, and that's it. Just let us see nothing.
Nah, believe it or not, you'd be surprised.
Yeah.
It's some girls out here putting pictures of their feet, and they're getting mad likes.
I don't know. Everybody got something out there.
Mad.
That's the power of the internet.
That's the fetish thing. Nah, but all right. So they're saying, you know, this is their claim.
Yeah.
And it's amusing to me. It's amusing to me because I've never really encountered a major corporation, a billion-dollar corporation at that, that ever really cared about people's feelings. So I would love to hear your input
on that. Is that their input on that?
Because it sounds like bullshit to
me. Is that like a revamp of like a mission statement kind of shit? Because, you know, like a lot of corporations are trying to do that, to act like they're here for the people, the community. But truthfully, it could just be a ploy to take over control. Well, you know, sinister mastermind kind of shit going on with social media.
Could take over control in what way?
Take over control of the platform that they were sort of losing. Like, they built a platform but a lot of people are benefiting from it, but not solely them. It's different when they're just benefiting through ad revenues and you can advertise and switch to a business account. But
how would it change how people make money on it is my question, because you still have access to your information, which you can easily provide to any potential sponsor.
Yeah, but if they're controlling on the back end, maybe they could follow that and just really shut it down and say it's a personal malfunction or glitch going on or needs an update, or, you know, it could be that kind of bullshit that they say, oh, our server's down right now, so we're doing updates and changing this and changing that. And it's either you can agree with it or you can just take away your account. Or maybe it'll be Facebook where you can't really remove your account. You can deactivate it, but they have your account.
Well, they keep your information.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. So, like, they have your always. Shit. So you can go change your profile name or act like you're going to go take it to another page, but then that's it. Like, they still will have all the shit you post and keep.
Of course.
Because
technically it becomes their property.
Yeah, it's sort of like what Uber Eats does, too, because they're getting called out for that shit. Like, if you have a restaurant, they go make a whole bunch of other similar sites with your restaurant's name.
Mm-hmm.
And then when they put your business up on the page, they built the page and the phone number is through them. So they can monitor the calls and the traffic that goes to your business for the orders.
Okay.
So in case you try to do some sneak shit around or eventually branch off, it's hard for you to really pull your name and identity and your web presence. Because now they have a control over that.
My thing is to answer what you were saying, Luke, is even though you can still access your own analytics, if say for instance, be it maybe an investor or another business that may want to collaborate with you, they don't have access to that. Maybe they won't want to ask you for your analytics. Maybe they just want to look at your page and see, okay, well, this person has this many followers, or maybe this person only gets this many likes or this many views. Next person.
Yeah.
So, but I mean, I guess that would especially tie in with smaller businesses and not necessarily, let's say, like, I guess the celebrity market or I guess companies that are already.
But they even do that on a small scale, like you said, like for instance, club promoters, they're based off of followings and presence. So like, all right, what makes you think that you really have a following? Let me see. That's the first thing clubs does. Let me see your social media.
That's the first thing.
Anything you deal with marketing or this and that, or you rap or you do music, let me see your social media.
Absolutely.
Let me see where your followers are. Let me see the, what's the shit called, man? The interaction, I guess, that you have.
The engagement.
There you go.
Yes.
Luke for the save.
I got you. Yeah. No, but I think what you're saying makes sense. My thought is just, how specifically would that intervene or interfere with certain business ethics when it's still a even playing field? Like, everybody still has the same circumstances when it comes to visibility, mm-hmm. and everybody still has the same access to their statistics. My only question is, how do you validate your engagement statistics when you're showing them to these potential sponsors? Because I mean, anybody can fake a screenshot.
Yeah.
You know, anybody can.
So I think that's a more pertinent question. But I think as far as Instagram is concerned, the real thing is the PR version is we're doing this for people's anxiety and insecurity, et cetera. I'm sure there's a much more beneficial behind the scenes reasons for them that
of course.
They're not going to pretend is the reason.
But it's definitely
or not
a
it's
good one, though.
I don't know.
It's definitely a good one to touch on, like, you know, like.
Because people are
on mental issues and depression
but
and self-awareness and shit like that.
Because of that.
Yeah,
but that's fucking awesome. Like,
it's genius.
My thing is, what are they doing?
Clap, Instagram, let's go.
What are they potentially doing behind the scenes that could be detrimental as pertains to this? Because as far as I'm aware and concerned, it's totally fine. Like, I see no issue with it.
I think they should personally put a dislike button on Instagram. Like, straight up, like, YouTube, motherfucker, like, let's put the thumbs down on there. I'm serious. Like, if you have a heart, then let's put the heart broken. Let's put a little fucking real shit to even the playing field. Because it puts you in the thing where, like, it's either you can not comment, or you only can comment with the positivity or an endearing emotion with a teardrop or a sad face. But no, you can always comment, you know what I mean? But sometimes you just want the fucking emoji on the platform when you're looking at the stories, like, you know, with the middle finger or the thumbs down or the, you know, the womp womp, you know, something like just like.
We need some sound drops on Instagram, too. We need some drops.
Motherfuckers will be deleting friends left and right. You're going to start really seeing who's really following you. Like, ah, shit. The hate comes alive. You know what I mean? But you need a little bit of that sometimes.
Sam, that's...
You need to have some tougher skin. Like, yeah, you know, like, our days, there was none of that shit going on.
I agree.
For what they're trying to talk now. Like, motherfucker, you have to go home and deal with it.
I agree.
And it's fucked up. Like, I'm glad they have programs and they're really, like... They're putting it out there now for kids. It's fucked up. Like, you see little kids hanging themselves and suicide and shit. That's bananas. Mm. But number one, the motherfuckers shouldn't be on social media. Like, you shouldn't have fucking 7-year-olds, 10-year-olds, 12-year-olds on social media.
What are they doing on social media?
Exactly, motherfucker. Yeah, put your face in the book and go outside and play basketball.
Like, what are you talking about? A perfect world.
Like, yeah, but I'm just, you know what I mean?
Not like,
yeah, I get it, you know?
Not to mention.
It's fucked up, though, because the corporate.
Into a technological era where it's almost a detriment to not let these kids learn some computer skills at a relatively early age. There's always that
the geniuses,
question of
bro.
Where's
like
the balance
they can
between
touch that shit out the box, never seen it, and figure that shit out. And I saw that shit like 10 years ago with my kid, bro. When he was a baby, he's just fucking grabbing shit and putting shit in. I'm like, damn, but like it wasn't like that for us, like in the Nintendo era for me.
Yeah, of course.
The Sega era, like... That was just that, like, oh, fascinating. But these niggas can grab computers and take them apart, put them back, grab phones and do this. No app before the app even comes out.
My friend Michael has a 3-year-old who can operate 3 iPads simultaneously.
That's nuts.
That's crazy.
I mean, I get it because of the times.
Yeah.
But my thing is that these same grown people who are complaining about, complaining or getting depressed about likes and this and that, a lot of them did grow up in our era.
Yeah.
You know, so it kind of
You think like grown folks are still like just being all depressed and sad about some social media shit?
Yeah. You don't see people doing the most to try to get.
I see people doing the most to try
women.
To get niggas be doing the most too. Niggas be extra.
I mean,
at least women now, like, my bad, but like I see women doing the most, but they making the most out of it and it's becoming a monetary thing.
Not for all of them.
If
it becomes monetary, then I get it.
Yeah, like they running that whole Snapchat premium, that OnlyFans. They doing their little sponsors and Bang Energies and, you know, doing all this bullshit weight loss shit when they ain't even in the gym. They just seeing a mean surgeon. But, like, I get it.
They took a trip to
the I'm trying to see the dudes really finesse the bag out of the social media things except for the workout dudes. That's the only guys I really seen making that little... You know, social media impression is the workout guys. I ain't seen the average Joe just finding a way to finesse it. Like, my nigga, like, I do simple shit. Like, send me some money on my simple shit, you know?
I mean...
That doesn't mean they're not out there, though.
Yeah, that's...
I mean, unless they have some kind of business. And I think that's what I'm saying. Like, I think a lot of people are concerned about this because they have small businesses or, say, like you said, the guys who are working out.
Yeah.
You know, they may have, you know, they may want to gain new clients. Maybe they're trainers.
Yeah.
And if they don't have, you know, likes or if they don't, if people can't see what, I guess, their stats are, maybe somebody might be like, maybe he's not the best. Or, you know, like, I could see how it could hurt people in that situation. But I'm just really wondering what the real agenda is. That's where I'm at. I'm wondering what the real agenda is because I don't buy the PR cover up. I don't buy the, you know, like, what is it? What's up?
No. Listen.
Oh, no, I'm just saying, no. I just don't buy it. Like, I'm just
wondering.
You can
only speculate at this point, though, because unless you are a high-ranking executive at Instagram, you pretty much don't know the real motivation.
Yeah. Maybe next year we'll know. Maybe in a little.
And if we never know, maybe it was harmless anyways, and they just did a real good PR move on another really intelligent strategic move.
Yeah.
Or could it be that Instagram could die? Do you guys ever see?
Nah, I don't
Instagram
believe in
dying?
That. No,
they absolutely could be phased out.
TikTok,
time has shown time and time again that it really comes down to
what the people
operations
want.
Operations versus the people. Like, there's a reason that TikTok is coming up insane.
That's why I was saying TikTok.
There's a reason that Snapchat was able to compete massively for a long time with Instagram. It just depends on whether... And you got to remember, as these executives age into their situation, they only get more greedy about their circumstances, and that ends up taking the lifeblood out of their operation in the long run. But that's how a new person always comes up. That's what happened to MySpace. That's what happens to everybody.
But I feel that it's more like a demographic thing. It's more of the younger people. Like TikTok was
it's
the young people.
That, so was Facebook. That, Facebook started as a college-only thing.
It was a college-only thing.
But then look what Snapchat is. It was the kids. TikTok is the kids. And it's putting it out there. And then
Snapchat
it's also
aged up too.
It's also where you put it at. Like TikTok started off
like
in Asia
right now.
So you gotta look at how many fucking people out there and into all that shit and the karaoke shit and the sing along stuff. That's their culture.
The Asian culture.
The same thing people said about Snapchat before it aged up to 35.
Yeah, motherfuckers still use Snapchat. Like, do we?
Absolutely, but the market kind of carved itself up.
Like, I think we just keep it in there.
The premium thing.
Your Snapchat friends.
The premium thing carved its own lane out.
Yeah.
And Instagram made impressive moves to eliminate a lot of the competition within them.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean that TikTok isn't in a position to do the same thing, because the way they're. The smaller entity is always going to have the advantage strategically, just not resourcefully.
Gotcha. That makes plenty of sense, because that's what I want to say with the whole Instagram thing. Like, granted, you may not have the followers and the likes, and the people won't be able to see the likes going through your page or scrolling.
Mm.
But what people can do that they can't determine with likes is gauge the content to understand that is a good product, or that is a good visual, or that is a good
that's
video,
true.
Or that's a good photograph, or this shit looks popping and hot. You don't need to see likes to see a good fucking thing on Instagram.
Right.
Like, if it's hot, it's hot.
Right.
If it's funny, it's funny. If it's, you know, if it's stylish, it's stylish. I'm not going to determine, like, oh, well, that shit's, like, dumb, hot and fresh.
Mm.
But that shit only got fucking 103 likes.
Yeah.
Only got 2,000 likes. Nah, nigga, if you want it, you want it. Like, if it's dope, it's dope.
So, do you guys think that there'll be a decline in Instagram usage as a result of this?
Well, maybe not as a direct result, but over time I still think it's possible.
What is the total users of Instagram? Because I know like Facebook had it and this shit kept dropping and dropping with all the little, you know, data breach and shit like that.
The data breach.
Yeah.
Breach. Mm-hmm.
100 million active.
Yeah.
111 million in 2019.
And Facebook has what, billions?
Surpass that.
Wow.
Facebook's in the billions already with their users.
Wow.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
I would really like to see what active users means in their definition.
Yeah, especially
though.
That could just be a whole bunch of dead accounts.
That could literally be like active within the past 5 years or something.
Yeah.
Not to mention a lot of people have many different accounts.
Nah, dude, because you're almost saying that's a fucking third of the world, man. Like, fuck out of here.
Yeah.
Literally,
don't kill me, Mark Zuckerberg. I got to do that, Kanye.
No, but you're definitely right about
that. Don't throw no hitters in my head, yo.
But at the same time, it has expanded globally, and there is, you know, India and China. Well, I guess China doesn't have Facebook; they have Weibo and shit, right?
Yeah,
China's way more specific about what they let happen.
Yeah, they're a little bit more strict. I think
I like
about
you,
it,
but I don't like it. You know what I mean? Yeah.
No, they're mad.
China, motherfucker, they follow
your
walk.
The fucking government. That's it.
You can't jaywalk across that bitch without fucking being exiled.
If you're lucky.
Yeah, right. Shit, dude.
Nah, y'all are nuts. So that's that. So now, you know, nobody can keep stunting on their likes, and we'll see where it goes from there.
Yeah, but they did that. Remember that one time they did the sweep, too? I know we got to keep it moving, but remember when they did the sweep and they rid of all the fake accounts and all the fake likes?
Yeah.
And then, like, all your rappers and all that shit just started falling off. Like, ooh.
Right. That was another thing that I wanted
to touch
on. That
was, like, what, 15? 15, 16? 16, maybe.
Like, 16,
they
did
a couple small phases.
Yeah,
also.
They was like, woof, woof, woof.
Yeah.
Just eliminating bots.
Now, like one last point on that. Do you guys believe that this has anything to do with how many people use outside, especially, you know, international companies to help boost their likes and boost their views, and the fact that these Instagram users are paying these outsourced companies and not Instagram directly? Could this be playing a part? Because
maybe a smaller part, but it's really, at the end of the day, just another variable within that issue.
Okay.
Like, some people have more likes. Some people are smart enough to look at their engagement and go, oh yeah, that's totally fake. There's no way you have 3 million followers and 40 likes on that last
post.
Exactly.
That's a lot of shit I look at too, is the ratio. Now, I treat it more or less like, for whatever you have, you should have like a 10% response at the minimum.
I agree.
You know, at the minimum. So when I see motherfuckers, you got 100,000 likes, B, but you know, you fucking hitting a percent of it, 2-3%. Like, obvious, that shit doesn't, that really shit doesn't make sense.
A lot of them are very obvious. So, like, moving along, so into this business current event, streaming. Well, this is different because this is streaming. So
Streaming,
since we're going to get into music in a bit. Disney Plus. What have we heard about Disney Plus? What do we know about Disney Plus?
They're a conglomerate, so, like, they're taking over everything.
Well, Disney is a conglomerate.
The Marvel, the Hulu, the ESPN, the Fox.
The FX.
Yeah, FX. Yeah, that's part of it. Yeah, so
Marvel.
They have a news with them too, or no?
They bought
Fox.
The entirety of 20th Century Fox.
Yeah, okay.
We're talking a $80 billion deal.
Yeah.
But that happened like last year, and it finally got finalized. Mm-hmm. It was a go, right?
That kind of deal takes a long time.
Yeah, because they're competing against what, Warner Brothers, or like, who is the other, Comcast? Who is, like, trying to
compete with who?
Now, before Disney,
the
like
company, it's a Viacom.
Viacom?
I think so.
Okay.
I think that's the parent company that is the major competition. But
yeah,
no one's going to beat Disney at this point.
So Disney. What's going to happen with Netflix and chill, man?
It's going to get bought by Disney.
It's
going to be Disney and chill.
Disney and chill. And apparently Hulu is going to be where they're going to have their adult entertainment.
40% of Hulu.
Can you really splack to Disney, though?
What do you mean?
Like, Disney content, like, is that really the move? To, like, yo, baby, let's
Well, that's why they Disney's bought Hulu.
That's why they got Hulu, so they can create original adult content.
They're not looking to only be family friendly. They're just looking to hide the other parts.
Nah, but Disney always did that, though. Like, when Disney wanted to do the family shit, it's Disney. When they do the adult shit, it's Touchstone's Pictures back in the day. You know what I mean? Like, it's just
exactly.
They
always
got
their
the
money
other shit.
Coming in.
They
that's
got
like
money
back
in, coming
they
in.
Wanted a rated R movie, motherfucker. We're giving you this label. We want to do rated G, PG, Disney.
So, do you guys foresee anything?
I heard they're going to buy Pornhub.
Come. Right. For real?
I wouldn't be surprised if they secretly already owned that entire industry.
You didn't hear about that? You heard about that?
I don't doubt it. Nah, you're right.
Was it the Pornhub shit that offered T.I.'s daughter? You heard about that shit?
Pornhub? Nah.
I heard that was
T.I.'s daughter.
They literally, the Pornhub, I think, president came out saying that was absolute lie.
Oh, it was bullshit.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I gotta bring me privy to that. What was
that? They're just trying to give her $1 million for the virginity shit to lose it, supposedly.
Oh my god, how disrespectful.
Allegedly false rumor.
Yeah. Oh, I hope so.
I can believe that, though, that's false.
Well,
I mean, they're pretty good with PR.
I could believe that with Bang Brothers or like Reality Kings or something.
Well, yeah, it would be someone smaller like that.
Yeah.
Well,
the major ones are really good at that.
Well, to the listeners who may not be aware of the whole T.I. virginity hymen thing. T.I., what was it, about 2 weeks ago?
It's about his daughter, y'all. I'm not saying
this is about his daughter. He basically came out saying, I don't remember. I don't know, Luke, if you can remember what outlet it was. I don't know if it was through his exact
podcast. No, it was like his podcast thing.
It was on his podcast.
Yeah.
Not his podcast. It was on someone else's, an all-female podcast.
Even more interesting.
Okay, okay.
All right. So where he basically said that he goes to go get, you know, takes his daughter to the gynecologist, and she's 18. And so there was this huge outrage, you know, X, Y, and Z, and you know, there was mixed reviews. But I don't get it, though.
He's the father of the daughter. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
What's your opinion?
I don't have a daughter, but I completely believe, like, every father should be involved with their children's, you know, healthcare and checkup and shit. I don't know to what extent.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, like, I can't say that. You know, you're a female. You're someone's daughter. I think you could probably touch on that. That's more of a subject.
Right.
You know what I mean? But yeah, back, I don't know what she's a grown woman or what. She's still 18.
She's 18. She's 18.
She could grow herself, ain't it?
Yeah.
Well, she would if he wasn't forcibly taking her.
Is he in the waiting room or
I think
in there with the you know?
No.
She's
all right, so here's what it is. He was on the Ladies Like Us podcast, which is hosted by Nazanin Mandi.
Miguel's wife. Nazazine.
Got you.
Yeah.
So he was saying, literally, he takes her every single year himself.
Yeah.
Forces her to sign the legal documents allowing the doctor to tell him.
Yeah.
Which I think is what everybody's skipping over. He's breaking the fucking law.
That's HIPAA, right?
She can sue the shit out of him.
That's HIPAA law, really.
He's literally coercing her into signing documents allowing the doctor to give him the information.
Because she's 18, though, at this point, but all the other times...
It is
like,
against HIPAA law, but if she decides...
All the other times, though, he was the parent. Like, he's the parent, so he is the guardian.
Yeah.
So until that visit, then yeah, maybe. And, you know...
But if she gives him...
Well, either way, that visit happens, so what's the real argument? Yeah. I mean, I would love to hear your argument against it, because I just... I don't have any...
I wouldn't know about that part of it, like, you know, like, for, like, you know, going and get your shit...
Oh, okay. Well, let me give my female opinion.
Variables like sex can be totally unrelated as to breaking your hymen.
Yeah, exactly. But sometimes
other ways to have sex.
Yeah, like, sometimes you can have sex and it doesn't break.
It's very insecurity, and no one's having the empathy for him just being a dumb dad. Everyone's either shitting on him or supporting him like an idiot. That's how I see it.
Here's my thing: as a daughter, and obviously in my teenage years, I went through my series of issues with my mother, which I won't get too into. But
next episode.
Nah, but you know, my own mother never, and my mother was very strict. My mother never even imposed that on me. Like, my mother never did anything like that.
So now, like, to know the information or like
she would inquire, say, like, she would ask me, you know, and she could speculate and she could have thought whatever she thought. Yes, of course, obviously as a teenager I wasn't always honest.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, to impose that, especially at the age of 18, I believe is a little intrusive. It is against the law to a certain degree, because if she signs over the HIPAA papers and gives it over to him, then it's perfectly legal.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. This is where I'm like, come on, fam. You're T.I.'s daughter.
Yeah.
Your father has been a multi-platinum, one of the biggest rappers in Atlanta your entire life.
Yeah.
Right? So that means that you've been around producers, you've been around studios, you've been around this, you've been at parties, you know all these men in the industry. You're going to tell me this girl?
But
potentially. All right. Allegedly, because this girl never lived a regular life. So regular, like, you know, going to school, school girl, kind of like innocent, you're buckled down at the house kind of life.
No.
Under my, like, what I would assume, because you don't live a regular life when you live with both of your parents being celebrities.
Yeah, big time.
Both of your parents are celebrities. So you mean to tell me that you're that naive, I'm speaking as a parent,
mm-hmm.
you're that naive as to think that My daughter's not doing anything. Like, I don't know. Like, I just think it's ridiculous.
I think
I'm not
maybe
telling
that's
nobody
more
how
of the reason, though, because they're actually, like, very, very involved with their children. And so that's even more of a reason. Like, look, like, we come from something. So you got to also look out for the namesake, your rep, your parents' rep, your family. You got to be a role model in a certain way to your younger siblings.
Right.
And your daddy's already letting you know what kind of fucking dudes is out there. Like, you know what
true,
I mean? Like,
true.
So, I think
viable through communication.
Yeah, but
not
that,
forcible nah, procedures but, that literally
I,
don't even
I would believe she a virgin, G.
What he...
I don't believe it either.
Exactly. They don't even prove. They just gave her the guidelines to trick her dad. It's like, oh, this is what I gotta maintain to make him think everything is what he wants it
She's
to be.
Got money, man. Come on. Like, and at the end of the day,
well,
ultimately...
let's talk about how he socially ruined her life for the next 5 years. She had to shut down all her accounts. She's, like, distraught. She's openly, publicly distraught by this.
Yeah.
It's not right.
Yeah. Come
that?
On. You're putting
Are
your
you
business
kidding me?
Out there.
An 18-year-old girl, her virginity is... spread to the world,
that's
and that becomes the biggest topic of conversation on every podcast.
Yeah,
her virginity is what
well,
we're
obviously
about right
she got to be a virgin though, because then some nigga would have came out there trying to brag and boast or do some fuck shit.
Really,
like
with
that.
T.I. as her daddy?
Well, I mean, realistically, that could be happening, but not going viral.
Some fool would have tried to shoot a shot for his claim of fame. There's nigga, you see what motherfuckers do out there. Motherfuckers can go.
You can't prove it. It's hearsay.
Go
so a lot
go out
of
there with a brick on the table, their guns on papers, on violation house arrest, and be out in the street and filming and posted and world star and shit, dog, just to get jammed up. Niggas are stupid.
Right.
You feel me?
But ultimately,
we live
look.
In that age where you care more about this.
But that doesn't change that
then,
how
then,
he's maneuvering isn't necessarily what he should be doing.
Yeah.
This should be a communication based thing with his daughter.
If anything, I think it should be the mother.
Where did I was about to say, what did the mama say about
this? This is what, this is
also,
how I.
Well,
if
he
anything.
Wouldn't allow that.
Is that Tiny's daughter or what?
It should be the mom.
No, it's not Tiny's daughter.
Okay.
That's another factor.
Oh.
But on top of
that
changes there's also him openly and publicly in similar podcasts proudly discussing his 15-year-old son having sex all the time. So he's just really digging the hole. That's all it is. He's
like,
digging
a PR hole. Diaz, my dad, bitch.
PR
like,
hole. Why? Because of this podcast?
Well, he going on the Red Talk, like, to oh, talk Jada? About
he's
it.
He's trying
yeah.
to clear it up on the Red Talk. He's hoping Jada can help
Jada
him.
Can. Jada and Will can save the day.
Y'all got to bring out the dictionary when we watch this one. Shit.
The biology book.
T.I. No, wait. What are you talking about?
T.I. got to go into words. Yeah, boy.
I mean, he's got a vocabulary, but it's not that wild. It's not.
It's the way he speaks, man. He puts a little you know, a little flavor and flair to that, man.
I mean, yeah, because, you know, but then again, so do I. You know what I'm saying? But people like,
I'm not gonna, it's you, T.I., and Joe Buttons, boy. You motherfuckers just be coming out with words. Like, all right.
It's just, I think that comes with being a writer. I think that's just like, yeah. You know, like when you're a writer, you just, it just comes naturally. But I mean, hey, you know what? All right. I don't know. I don't like telling people how to parent. You know, whatever it is, it is. If that rumor is true, that's wild. Because she's already a millionaire. The about them, like, I guess, what you guys said in the beginning, where they wanted to pay or...
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, they already came out and said
that's not. Oh, okay, okay. That's horrible.
But that probably helped them out, too.
What?
Like, I'm saying, like, just, they got the attention as a porn company. Like, oh, shit, and people would believe that.
Ah, okay, okay, okay.
You never know. That's true.
Everybody with their business moves, man. Everybody with their business sneaky
controversy
tactics.
Sells.
But as you're halfway through this, I don't want to keep you on that topic.
Yeah. All right, so let's move on to music. So on
music.
The most interesting topic, right?
Is it? Yeah, for me.
One of them, yeah, for me.
I live for it.
All right, so do I. Music. So on my Instagram, on the Ivy Talks podcast Instagram, I had posted... for a couple people to list, I asked a couple questions. One of them was, and of course, I want y'all feedback on top five albums of 2019, hip hop and R&B thus far. I know that we still have like a month out, but you know,
which to be fair is always confusing because when someone drops in November or even early December, you don't have enough time to digest that album to even put it in contention.
But that's the fourth quarter kill. You know what I mean?
That's true.
Yeah,
if
that's
you
the
can
fourth
do
quarter
that,
kill.
I'm waiting for I'm going to see what Jim Jones following up. He's trying to come in the fourth.
I mean,
with
he
what
might.
He already did with that L.
But if you come in the fourth,
with
you got
El Chapo.
You got to hit.
It can't be like, ooh, maybe I got to sit on this for a little bit. It's got to be.
But
like,
who's coming in the fourth?
Undeniable. I don't.
See, it's hard, man. Like,
I know Denzel's about to drop Speedboat. That's all I can remember.
So, anyways, I wanted to read off some of the responses that I got.
Did y'all see the new Jesus is King 2 tweet?
Oh, with Dre?
Yeah.
Is that really true? Or is that some bullshit?
It's a picture with them together.
I know, but is that some motherfucker photoshopping shit and just putting it out there?
He was just with Joel Osteen. Jesus.
Oh, okay.
Kanye's so he photoshopped it, which is really bizarre.
Yeah.
It's still interesting if that happened then, because that's another story.
What the fuck would Dre do? But I like to see Dre get back, man, because the last shit he did was that shit straight out of Compton shit. And
which
that was
fire.
Like what, like fucking like
the thing
5
that kills
years
me
ago.
Is like Kanye can already make a great production album.
Yeah,
I needed someone that was gonna fix the lyrics.
Yeah, that.
But sorry, go on. What you were saying?
So I wanted to list off. I mean, and I definitely want to get some feedback from you guys. But some of the albums that I got. One of the one of the responses I got for top five albums of 2019 thus far, which we're coming to a close anyway.
Igor.
Post Malone, Hollywood is Bleeding.
Didn't listen
Post was
it.
Dope.
And that was on my list as well. I agree. Wale, wow, that's crazy.
Yeah, you're right. I see what he did, though. He was at the Soul Train shit. So, you know, shout out to Wale.
I'm not going
to
front.
It was Wale and Jeremiah. They did a little performance and shit. Shout out to that.
I mean, I rocked with the Wale album. I'm not sure if I put that in my list, but
MMG,
all right.
Shout out to Rosé.
All right. Yes. I mean, it might be like a close. It might be in there. It might squeeze in there. I got Young Thug, So Much Fun.
Yeah, Thugger's always a shit.
FKA Twigs, Magdalene. Has anyone heard about them?
No.
I never even heard
of
that.
That's a Mary reference? I never heard of that.
I never. But
well,
we got to do
Magdalene,
our research.
Magdalene, I know.
Well, we got to do some research on that. And yes, Tyler the Creator, Igor. All right. So
I'm a fan of that dude.
Now
I give him his props for what he did and how he set it off and how he made his lane, and he still does that, but he's just not my flavor, man. It's kind of,
I respect that.
You know, like, I respect it a lot because he's had a run. Tyler the Creator and the whole crew.
I just respect people who disagree with me.
My cousin be pushing him and jumping on him when he came out, but it's just not my thing. And
I also grew up on him.
You know, it's like a little bizarre for me, man.
I rock with him. He says a lot of questionable things in some of his lyrics.
That's not for me. Even that freestyle he did on Flex.
That's specifically that kind of stuff. I feel like people who see those things,
shock value.
He's doing shock value freestyling on Flex, but I feel like people misinterpret that as what his content is within the newer albums. And really, the newer album, I mean, if you go back to like Wolf and things, he does say a lot of things.
I feel
like
he's
that.
Pompous too, though. I don't like his personality.
He's definitely pompous, but most good artists are. Like you like T.I. He's not more pompous than T.I. Period. So
nah, but T.I. backs it up with like we're gritting and he's a linguist in a way. Like he backs it up.
You're not appreciating
songs.
What Tyler's really bringing.
He makes
to the
street
table
shit. Like you know, like T.I. is T.I. man. Like he
can't even do what Tyler does though. Like the production on Cherry Bomb. Like what Tyler brings together.
But is it about production or is it about rap? So
it's about the combination. It's about the entire record and his ability.
Tyler doesn't. My bad. Go ahead, Luke. Tyler don't spit like T.I., man. T.I. got a catalog for a motherfucker certain kind of content.
In terms of lyricism, we're not talking lyricism.
That's what I'm saying. Like I can't take a rapper.
He doesn't compare to T.I.
I look at the rapper for the rap, because if I have to go off of production value, then there's plenty of rappers who got bomb-ass beats.
Fan, so there's a lot of debate within
but
that.
But Thugger spits, though.
I mean, then you've never heard some of Tyler actually spitting, I guess.
Yeah, he can spit,
but I just don't. I just probably don't like him, bro.
Yeah, it's
like,
just not
that's
your flavor.
It's just
what I want you to say.
I seen the videos and the weird
specific,
shit.
I can argue it.
Just,
but if it's just not your flavor, I can't.
Yeah,
argue
it's
that.
Just like
because I asked you about Frank Ocean even earlier.
Definitely not, man.
Because I literally feel the same about T.I. right now. I can't listen to him, even though I grew up like I'm Illy changed me as a rapper. I was in high school rapping, and I had to rethink everything because I'm Illy blew my mind to the stratosphere. Yeah, I mean, I wasn't doing certain types of things at that point. I was really into Wayne and a lot of just general Southern rap at the time.
Mm-hmm.
And he did his own Southern rap that was just more intelligent in a way that gave me permission to be more intelligent as well.
What do you think about Big Crit?
I love him.
But it's street and it's intelligence and it's
yeah, but it's way less pompous.
Nah, of course, but it's that's food for the mind, man. To me, Crit speaks like.
Yeah, no, and I love that, but
T.I. draws some knowledge too, though.
Yeah, but it's intertwined with so much ego that I don't feel like deciphering what's what.
Got you.
All right, so.
Words from Luke.
And words from Luke.
Yeah, let's stop taking over the Ivy Talks podcast.
No, I enjoy listening to this. Some of my answers. Okay, no, I want to read off some answers from one of my UK followers because obviously they have a little bit. You know, there are artists over there. I'm not saying anything negative about them, but, you know, they have obviously a different following. We have here A Moment Spent Loving You by Xavier Omar and Sango. I know Sango has a pretty decent following even here.
Oh, yeah, that's a big name.
Yeah, he's a big name. We got Chasing Summer by Sir. That was also on my list. These Feelings Again by Snow Allegra. And if you guys don't know about Snow Allegra,
why does that name sound familiar?
She's a beast. Definitely, yeah, y'all got to study up on her. And she put the Lost Boy YB in Corday, and he was definitely
he dope though.
Yo, he's mad dope. He was on my list as well. And in terms of my list, I put Chasing Summer Sir as well. Post Malone Hollywood is Bleeding. Chris Brown Indigo, YBN The Lost Boy, and Summer Walker Over It. Which I'm going to touch on Summer Walker.
Yeah, she's dope too, though. She getting, like, everybody going crazy for her.
She's amazing. Like, she's a dope artist. Heavy. I got a little thing to say about her before we, a little segment to introduce about females in the industry before we end this podcast. And one of the other questions that I had asked, well, I mean, do you have any albums? Do you guys have any albums that you would want to add, even if you don't have, like, a set five?
It's hard, man. I, like, you know, my genre of hip hop that I'm into is a different cut. So I definitely haven't been following the R&B scene for a minute. It's just not my thing.
Okay.
You know, like, it's cool for the ladies.
Okay. You like ladies, right?
Yeah, who doesn't?
All right. Well,
that's a different question to ask in these days. Shit.
All right.
I'm like a last of a dying breed out here, but, you know.
Geez.
Hey.
All right.
What?
I'm taking that as a ludicrous reference.
Yeah, my PD says I...
Shut up about your damn PD.
Shit.
All right, so, like, whatever. Just who are you feeling in 2019? Mixtape, album, even if you just throw out two names out there. Like, we could be schooling listeners to.
I can tell you who I'm not feeling. I'm disappointed in that Dave East mixtape.
For me. I was disappointed
too. I'm disappointed in that.
Check out the first couple, and I
lot of hype.
The intro really threw me off.
I was kind of like, what? Like, as I was like, the production, like,
I see where you're trying to go, but like, fam, like, just no.
But did he get there?
Yeah, no.
Yeah, it didn't really. I'm glad that all three of us.
I'm glad he's doing that. Like, I'm glad he got the Wu-Tang gig. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just.
All right. What about you, Luke? Any albums?
I was expecting more, though. Let me just put it that way. Like, I was expecting something
a lot more
different and harder and more from him than what I got.
Yeah, I mean, we understand who he is.
Exactly.
What he's capable of. That's
big,
why.
Big time, man.
He's fantastically talented.
He's like, you know, he connected, man. But he's that B-list dude, like, who can easily make it to the A squad. I feel. You know what I'm saying? Like, from when I seen him and putting out the stuff. But again, when he came out the first time, I felt he didn't have enough material.
Yeah.
He didn't have enough viral material, enough video material. But, you know, he's working, he's steady, he's connected. So hopefully, you know, better material will come.
But maybe
more songs, more commercial appeal, more songs for the street or songs for the radio.
But maybe he's not as interested in the commercial appeal. Because, I mean, to be fair, if you can be that successful in hip-hop but still doing what you specifically want to do, I can't call that anything but commendable. I mean, maybe it wasn't the most successful release, but the one thing I did appreciate about it is that he's not over here pandering to people. He's trying to find what he wants to do, at least.
It's definitely his own thing. So you're saying he's doing like the whole go left and it becomes like, right, that J. Cole Nas route? Like,
maybe he just needs a couple projects to develop that style or something. I don't know. But I'll still check him out. You know what I mean? Like, one bad release doesn't put me off of
anybody. No, of course. So, all right. What about one of the other questions that I posted was best feature verse of 2019, and I'll give my answer first. My answer was 21 Savage and J. Cole on A Lot.
J. Cole spat, but I can't say that's the best verse for 2019.
Best feature verse.
Feature verse, definitely.
That was my opinion. I think in terms of his cadence, what he was saying, his bars, just hands down. I personally haven't heard a feature like, and J. Cole on his features lately has been bodying them.
I mean, it's definitely strong. It's a super solid feature, but I don't disagree with Lex in that vying for that position is important as far as best feature of the year. I think, also lending to not answering the best album question, I'm just not researched enough in this current year and, you know, more of the mainstream music to actually give a viable answer to that.
I'm going
to
dig in the crates.
All right, y'all both got homework to do.
I got some homework.
I'm a local correspondent. Yeah. I'll give you local answers.
Even better.
But local is what you need, though.
You want albums locally? I'll give you that.
All right, so let's switch it up a little bit. I want to talk about something a little bit more life topic-ish, and then I'll end the podcast with my little segment. So about females in the industry. One of the things that I wanted to touch on, and also in kind of in the same room as Instagram with small businesses and people trying to put on themselves and create their own streams of revenue. How do we feel about people who say, hey, you know what? You got to go to college. You got to get a 9-to-5. This is the way to go. Versus
you're out of touch.
Other people.
Those are probably the people who own the businesses who are trying to make you fucking work for them for 30 years.
This is a very important question. Versus people who are quote unquote considered dreamers. You know, like,
I don't think that line is so defined anymore. I mean, most people understand that it's not even a dreamer thing. It's logical to not go to school anymore because it's literally indentured servitude.
Yeah.
So, okay, and then what about working a 9-to-5?
You got to...
Hey, staying somewhere for 30 years actually, and then retiring and your pension.
I saw some shit on Instagram. You know, I see a couple memes and shit. I think
how
next
many likes
week,
did it have?
Can you see the likes?
Yeah, I don't know. Let me go see.
You can't see the likes, can you?
No, you can't. Where the fuck is this chick at?
That's the funny thing about that also is you can still click on others and just... If you do a consistent swipe of like... How quick, like, you know, basically, if I swiped down and that was about 100, it's really easy to estimate about how much people are getting. Like, it's not totally unavailable information.
To be honest with you,
I'm just saying it's not like you don't have access to it. Right. It's just they're going to make you count it. You can still see everybody that liked it. That's my point.
But who's going to do all that?
No, but one click others and one you? Swipe. If you, you know how quickly you're swiping, I can go, okay, that was 50 people.
Okay. Well, what is this that you're pulling on?
Let your 9-to-5 help train you and pay your bills, then go home to work on your dreams. Overtime. Put it to life. Anything is possible.
Sounds like Dame Dash. Be your own
less
boss.
Arrogance. Oh.
With less arrogance. Yeah, but you know that's Dame Dash's like
Dame,
mantra.
Dame Dash is like a tall, short cup of coffee, boy. Like early. Like you gotta be ready for that shit, boy. That man got the energy, but you know he put it down. Imagine hip hop without a Dame Dash. That's a lot of shit missing in the game.
I'm a huge. I love
very
Dame Dash.
Intricate part, man.
A lot of people say he's arrogant, but he's a very intelligent, articulate.
Yeah, but
man.
That doesn't change what he's done.
His contribution is up there. His contribution is.
I love it.
A Russell Simmons and a Diddy. Like, he is an intricate part, like, you know what I mean, of New York hip-hop and hip-hop.
He's straightforward. He's like,
that's what I'm saying.
This, and this. And if you don't like it, all right, great.
Not everybody can deal with that.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I love
it. That's a hard spoon, hard spill to swallow with that kind of personality.
Right, but I'd rather somebody kick it to me straight than be like,
yeah, of course.
You know, that's just me. I know a lot of people can't. I
guess
know.
It goes back to that whole not motherfuckers not liking you and committing suicide shit. A lot of niggas can't. Like, oh my God, 3 likes. Rope dangling and shit.
Man, the shit that I done been through in life. You think if someone tells me they don't like me, kid, I throw you. Yeah, come on, fam.
But you ain't hit the heart, though.
Oh, get out of here.
But you ain't hit the heart, though.
Oh, come on. But anyways, okay, so I wanted to introduce a new segment that I'm going to be touching on every week. And one of the things I believe is that the industry, especially the music industry, is predominantly male-dominated. And therefore, I wanted to start highlighting females in the industry that I believe are commendable, be it signed, not signed, new, already kind of somewhat a vet in the game. Not really a vet, but just coming up. And... just to show love to fellow females in the in the industry, because I, you know, me being somebody who just entered this industry as a songwriter, I've already had my share of experiences and you know, so anyways, this week I wanted to show some praise to Summer Walker.
Mm-hmm.
And Summer Walker. Yes. She was on my top 5 album list
for the
year.
Right?
She just won a Soul Train Award.
Yeah.
And that was another thing that I wanted to touch on, not to get into something negative, but she gave a very short speech. She also went on her Instagram and she basically said that she was actually thinking about not going to the awards because she suffers from social anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
That she didn't anticipate that the fame and the touring and all of these things would be so much pressure. And so she was very nervous. So when she went up to you know do her acceptance speech, it was very short and to the point.
Yeah,
and she was criticized for
short.
It but my thing is this is like a lot of people need to understand that these people, quote unquote celebrities, are still human beings. And if this girl is new to the game, and if you look at all the accolades that she's accomplished in just this year alone, you cannot help but commend what she has. Raw talent. She makes dope music. Her album was fire. She features with God knows how many people. So what if she's not wanting to be in like the limelight and like the glitz and the glam? Like I understand, but artist development went away a long time ago, and that plays a huge part in that.
But
it's because no one knows how to develop an artist in the modern market.
But what is, you know, but if you could go perform several songs already to do your showcase and your shows, How come you can't throw a couple more words on that microphone?
She
in front
sits
of the
down at her shoulders.
To do, to
have you
fair.
Seen her perform?
Nah,
she sits
just,
at her shoulders. She well,
state that clear.
No, she's had a couple performances at her shows where she's holding a teddy bear. She's sitting down. She's not really looking like she's not.
Right?
You can see that she
that's
literally
definitely some
has
refund shit.
But her music is
motherfuckers
ill.
Motherfuckers don't be complaining at the show for some refund.
Her music is that ill, man. I don't know.
Nah, my nigga, you might as well listen to the jukebox at that point. Like, if a chick's in with teddy bears and not even engaging in the crowd and shit, nigga, if that microphone ain't coming, if you ain't doing okay Michelle shit in the audience or some Keisha Cole or one of them kind of things, they give you a show, you know, some
I
Fantasia.
Dig
like,
I dig it.
Like,
I
if you're going to get all this acclaim and you ain't got no presence, then nah, motherfucker, just drop
but,
CDs in a booth
but
and,
she's
and
still
don't come
the
out the
game.
Closet.
But she's still bodying the game.
But maybe she'll do that.
Maybe like, eventually.
There's nothing wrong with being the Frank Ocean or D'Angelo type. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
and Frank Ocean has been bodying the game since.
Yeah, but he does a show. D'Angelo does a show.
There's a difference between doing a show and just going up and talking on a major platform.
No, but she sings. She kills it.
I get that. Yeah. But... you get what I'm saying?
She's not Beyonce.
That's the whole thing, though. Like, when you, when now it becomes something different. Like, you can have great music, but now when you're traveling and doing shows, do you have that stage presence?
True.
That is a critical thing to set you apart. Like,
I mean, I don't like, know how long I mean? She's been performing, but realistically, there's a lot that goes into getting to that point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially
that's
if you had
like
a meteoric rise. Like, if you got
the
there
stage.
Quick, it's going to be way harder to get used to it.
Right.
I would be thrown off to be in front of, you know, 1,000+ people right now.
Oh, of course.
But I still at least have been in front of, you know, under 100-ish enough times where I could get my shit together enough to do it. And then after a few times doing it, I'll be more used to
comfortable,
that.
Comfortable, right. But,
I mean, that's why I ask if you know how long she has been actually performing on and at what level, because it just all factors into that. And realistically, people are fucking anxious these days.
Stage presence, nigga who kill it, the baby.
Oh. He's on my best
absolutely
OG niggas.
He's on my best new artist
shit.
Of the year. Sorry,
Busta
even
Rhymes.
Though he may not be that new. I mean, wait, but he's on the blow up this year.
Oh,
he's,
definitely.
He
certain niggas I seen though, like they kill a show, they kill an audience, like they eat that shit up.
He
but the baby, one of the new
he's
niggas.
Amazing.
But the other moves he's making right now, people are losing their shit over him just bringing out the Jabberwockies in the end of that fucking one video.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, the bop shit?
Yeah.
That's the Jabberwockies in it?
Yeah, at the end, the Jabberwockies come out and everyone loses their mind. Like, oh, shit.
Nah, dog, he's amazing, man.
Nah, he's ill. He's ill. And
$1 billion Baby Entertainment. Yeah.
Incredible.
That motherfucker's, what's
and
it?
His content.
For Stunner for Vegas. What's his name?
I don't know it specifically.
Yeah, the young nigga. He dope.
What's his name?
Stunner for Vegas or something.
Nah,
little young dude on the team, dog. He got another nigga. Like they doing something.
I mean, he's making moves. You know what? One of the
and
things
they look
I respect
like they
self-contained about
too.
One of the things I respect about the baby is even that last record. I don't remember the name of it. It slipped my mind. The record he made about his dad passing away.
Oh, the intro shit.
Yeah, the
intro.
That
shit hard.
That
shit
like
nice.
That, like the video, everything he says. Like, I don't feel like he's a gimmick. I don't feel
nah,
like
nigga, that nigga
I don't
dope.
Feel like he's fake. I don't feel like any of that. And he's just ill.
If
like,
I had to do a
he's
comparison,
ill. He's nasty.
He's animated like a Ludacris, but with a the same content and lyricism, but more street.
More street and a better
so
flow.
So I think he is. You know how Ludacris just came and set it off and was like bam and did numbers,
right?
I think the baby's the same thing, but just more gritty.
Right.
But very animated, very playful, but very serious content driven.
Yeah.
Has a badass team the way Chris came in.
Exactly.
So he is just
and
today's
also
version
just his
of it.
Aura of confidence.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nah, that's the man's potent.
He's funny.
And being as
interviews,
gritty as but treating
freestyles.
His fans the way he does is a thing that people miss out a lot. A lot of
right.
really street dudes don't build as powerful of a cult because they're too, you know, cool
street,
to
yeah.
be super nice to their fans.
Right.
And he's so confident that he doesn't give a fuck. He cares about his fans, but he's still gonna whoop somebody's ass at a Gucci store.
He's still gonna whoop his ass.
Yeah. Yeah, what happened with that shit? How did that shit? Like, I don't know. Did homeboy ever get retaliated? No, obviously not.
No,
so.
No. It was amazing. It literally
was
one of the
from
biggest spikes
his way.
In his brand recognition
yeah.
the whole year.
Yeah.
Wow.
Not even the music did it. A lot of it was just from a dude, like, you know, at the Gucci store, like,
taking video of him in the back. Like, yeah, look, it's the baby. And then he starts, like,
choking. Yeah, it was some beef from around the way from
there. What you gonna do? You ain't gonna do nothing.
His neighborhood or his area or some shit that just lingered.
The next video you see is from the baby recording.
Local artist or something.
Him, right. Dude, on the floor, laid out, giant dread, dude, mind you.
Yeah, like nigga, like
laid out outside in the underwear, yo,
in the mall, like pants on the ankles, kind of shit.
Solo,
wow.
It wasn't a security situation.
That's
it was
the thing.
The baby.
That's the thing. Some of, and that ties back to what I keep, like what I've said a couple times.
It's
like,
kind of risky, though.
These people are.
You feel me? But
he's showing us who he is.
Yeah, but the other nigga couldn't play that police card. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's risky for the baby to. If he did it or not, we don't know. You know what I'm saying? Like, just you can't go put hands on niggas when you got that kind of money.
It was played perfectly because nothing was shown.
Yeah, exactly.
Only the result.
Yeah,
the first video where he taunts him, and then the resulting video where he's laid out.
So that's still the thing. That's just putting you there, though. You get what I'm saying?
Like, the operation is so clean.
The law's a crazy motherfucker, dog. Like, you know what I mean?
It's
about that he say, she say shit video comes out. Niggas want to come and try to sue you and put liens and get money.
I'll give you that, but he's not... putting himself in.
Nah, I seen it. I remember that shit. Hey, we got a guest.
Oh, we got a guest. Right.
What's up?
My favorite, Kitty Kitty.
I told you, man. We bringing celebrities in here.
It's Jackie.
So. Gotta definitely leave this in the edit floor.
Yeah. We got a little guest, little king. All right, you kicking us out or what?
Nah,
but the baby's doing his thing. I look forward to see what he's doing in 2020. He's been on the major come up. And to sum up again, back to Summer Walker, I know. Let me give my props to Summer Walker as my female for the week that has been on the come up, that I would love to see her to continue to shine. Social anxiety or not, she's very talented, and she's a star.
Yeah, well, hopefully, you know, she comes out of that, because...
I hope so, too.
You wouldn't want to see her to get out the limelight and just stop recording because of that. Remember what happened to that one dude, Houston?
Yeah, I remember him. I like that.
Motherfucker lost
her
eye.
Yeah. You remember him?
That was showing our age here, but that shit was a jam in the club, though.
Yeah,
the nigga couldn't take it and take the pressure or whatever, and like he stabbed his eye out or some shit.
Oh, wow.
I don't think she's going to be that extreme, but, you know, still.
It might have been more than the music to side
just stop making music.
Yeah, that's a foundational issue, but still.
Yeah.
She'll come around, man. They're going to present that back.
Nah,
it could be a gimmick, nigga, to get more money, dog. Like,
it could
you know
be.
What I mean?
Nowadays, you never know.
Motherfuckers be getting the bag, yo. Like, they get that. You ain't never hear that shit back in the day. They tried to get Eminem, like, $6 million to perform. Nah, it was Prince or some shit, and nigga didn't want to take it. One of them two niggas, they gave him like a bag of $6 million. Like, one of them was like, nah, probably Prince. I can see Prince doing that shit.
Yeah, no. Prince, yeah.
He wasn't worried about money.
Yeah.
Prince was never worried about
Prince,
none of that. Nah, Prince wasn't worried about
they
it.
They wanted to give him like a $6 million bag, bro. He's like, nah, like, I'm not doing the show. Like,
nah, fuck. Prince wasn't worried about
one
any
show,
of that.
$6 million. Prince, back then.
Prince wouldn't even work with anybody who didn't own their masters. What's up?
Wonder if Prince would have hooked up with Jay-Z.
Huh?
Probably now if he was still around.
Who?
Prince and Jay-Z.
I mean, maybe.
Could have been like a Prince, Jay-Z, Beyonce collab. Something could have happened.
I would probably see him sooner with Beyonce.
Yeah, but you know, Jay-Z had to come in there and get a little 8-12 in there just because. Jay-Z the kind of nigga like ain't nobody making deals without the wife without me involved. You know, he's a low key, more professional Ike Turner nigga. Just gotta have my hands in it.
Speaking to Jay-Z, in closing, speaking to Jay-Z, since we were speaking about streaming stuff earlier, is it true that he apparently sold his 33% of Tidal?
To who?
I don't know exactly to who, but apparently he bought it for about 50-something million, and then he made $200 million on top of that.
Sweet. Well, that's the game.
That's that inspiration.
That's the game, yo.
And then, you
build
know.
Build a business or sell a business.
Build a business and flip that. That's Dame's. That was actually Dame's thing. But you know what, gentlemen? We're going to go ahead and wrap this episode up. It's been a pleasure. It's been fun. It's been informative.
Likewise.
And we'll be back next week. And shout out to my people in London, iLive UK.
Yeah.
Shout out to all my people out here in the 954 and 305. Shout out to all the listeners, the YouTube viewers. And this is your girl, Draya Ivy.
What up, what up? It's Lex, y'all. Hit me up, holla rock.
And the kitty cat has stepped out, so no longer can she give a farewell. And Luke, you good?
Tremendous.
All right, man. This is Ivy
Talks. That one liner.
I know. This is Ivy Talks episode number. Ah, that would be better. Ivy Talks episode number 9, and we are out.
You.
What's good? This is your girl, Draya Ivy, introducing my new show, Ivy Talks, the dopest podcast coming out of the beautiful city that is Miami, Florida, featuring the best artist interviews, covering the illest events in the city as we propel the culture of hip-hop and R&B. Make sure to check out Ivy Talks each and every Monday from 11 p.m. to midnight on iLive UK, changing the way you listen to radio. Let's talk.
You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio.